Black TV 24/7 News for the latest information relating to the Black experience. I'm Erin Elkins, and here are today's headlines. Our top story, explosive allegations out of Atlanta. Two men have filed lawsuits accusing Bishop Eddie Long of exploiting his role as pastor of New Birth Missionary Baptist Church to coerce them into sexual relationships when they were young members of his congregation. Maurice Robinson and Anthony Flagg, both in their early 20s, claim in their lawsuits that Long utilized his spiritual authority to coerce certain young male members and employees into engaging in sexual acts and relationships. The suit claims the congregation is likely unaware of the practices, but it also says church money was used to foster the relationships.
This is at the church, which reinforces how absolutely negligent and wrong and abusive and sick for a pastor to abuse these kids in this way.
If somebody would tell about your stuff, you'd be sitting up every day.
Both lawsuits claim that Long used money, cars, and gifts to entice the young men into sex, and that he also used the Bible to justify the intimate relationship. Members of New Birth Missionary Baptist Church were both stunned at the allegations and supportive of their embattled pastor.
Praying for him, I'm praying for protection for his family, and that basically that he just comes out of this with a clean slate.
I think that those who begin to judge him should wait until it all comes out. He's not that kind of person. Well, based on what I know, he's not that kind of person.
Craig Gillen, Long's attorney, said the pastor categorically denies the allegations. Long was appointed pastor of New Birth in 1987 when the church had 150 members. Today, New Birth sits on 250 acres, has more than 40 ministries, and over 25,000 members. In other headlines, disturbing details are emerging from a workplace shooting that took place at a Toledo, Ohio police department. A 27-year female police veteran is on administrative leave from the force as an internal investigation is underway as to why she allegedly shot another police sergeant. Witnesses say Sergeant Gloria Burks shot fellow police officer Sergeant Jeffrey Bechtel, who just celebrated 25 years on the force. Bechtel suffered a non-life-threatening gunshot wound to his upper right arm. Sources say Sergeant Burks, who is friends with Bechtel, doesn't even recall the shooting.
She was taken to the University of Toledo Medical Center, and she was admitted for medical reasons. I'm not going to comment. She's been relieved of duty, but she's also on sick leave right now.
Despite her mental state, Sergeant Burks could face criminal charges for opening fire in the workplace. Chief Navarre said the ultimate decision is in the hands of the district attorney. And those are our headlines. And now it's time for our trek across the nation. First stop, the Bronx. A church is in mourning after six members of their congregation died in a terrible van crash on the New York State Thruway. Reverend Simon White, his wife Zelda, associate pastor Titus McGee, and three other members of the Joy Fellowship congregation were killed when the van they were traveling in flipped over multiple times. 14 people were riding in the 1997 Ford heading to a church event when police say a rear tire ruptured. Philadelphia. Disturbing footage of a man on the ground being beaten by a police officer while other officers try to hold him down has gone viral on YouTube. The video begins with four police officers tackling 29-year-old Askia Sabor on a sidewalk. As he's on the ground, one officer continues beating him with a police baton. Police say that Sabor was blocking the store's doorway, and when they asked him to move, he refused and hit one of the officers. The beating lasted for more than 2 minutes. Columbus. An Ohio couple that gave birth to the city's first set of sextuplets are finally getting to take their children home. Mia and Rosano McGee had four boys and two girls. Meet Isaac, Josiah, Elijah, Rosano, Madison, and Olivia. Collectively, they weighed just 9.5 pounds at birth, but they're all healthy and doing well. The little ones are going through 48 bottles a day, about 300 diapers a week, and more formula than mom and dad care to think about. Luckily, the McGees have around-the-clock help from their church. And that's our trek across the nation. And now on the international front, Maiduguri. A police commissioner says members of a radical Muslim sect killed two people in northern Nigeria. The two victims were shot by men riding a motorcycle taxi, the 10th such slaying by the Boko Haram sect in recent weeks. The extremist organization also launched an attack on a prison on September 7th, freeing more than 750 inmates. Boko Haram, which translates Western education as sacrilege, has campaigned for the implementation of strict Sharia law in Nigeria, home to both Christians and Muslims. Cairo, al-Qaeda's North Africa branch, claimed responsibility in an audio message broadcast for kidnapping five French nationals that disappeared in the deserts of Niger. Seven foreign workers were kidnapped from a uranium mine operated by the French company Areva and were last seen headed toward the neighboring countries of Mali and Algeria with about 30 captors before vanishing in the vast desert. The message said fighters from the group overcame security in the area and kidnapped five French nuclear experts and said it would issue its demands to the French government shortly. France said it will do everything it can to free the victims, but declined to specify whether they were considering military action. And that's a look on the international front. And now, sports and entertainment. A spokeswoman for Aretha Franklin says the legendary singer's son has been severely beaten at a gas station in Detroit. Gwendolyn Quinn says in a statement that Eddie Franklin was attacked and has undergone surgery at a Detroit area hospital. The statement says three people may have been involved in the beating. No other details were forthcoming, and Detroit police say Mr. Franklin has yet to give them a statement. Eddie Franklin was a suspect in the 2002 fire at Aretha Franklin's million-dollar mansion in Bloomfield Township. He was later cleared and never charged in connection with the fire. Reports say Franklin has been released from the hospital. Let's pray that he makes a full recovery. For the third time in 4 years, the Denver Broncos are dealing with the death of a teammate. Wide receiver Kenny McKinley was found dead in his home of an apparent suicide. Authorities were called to McKinley's home at 3:35 p.m. and found his body in the second floor master bedroom. McKinley, a 2009 fifth-round draft choice out of South Carolina, was on injured reserve after hurting his left knee in August for the second time in 8 months.
Here he was happy, smiling, usual Kenny. And, in fact, I think he watched the Georgia game from my office up there because he was on crutches from his knee surgery. And I saw him up there right after the game. He was his usual self, and that's it's hard to comprehend how that could happen.
Police were called by a female friend of McKinley's who discovered the body after returning from an errand she ran with his young son. The sheriff declined to say if authorities found a suicide note. McKinley's death is the latest in a series of tragedies for the Broncos in recent years. Cornerback Darrent Williams was killed in a drive-by shooting on New Year's Day 2007, and 3 months later, backup running back Damian Nash collapsed and died after a charity basketball game in St. Louis. New York Jets wide receiver Braylon Edwards has been flagged for illegal motion. Translation? He was arrested in Manhattan and charged with driving while intoxicated. Edwards was pulled over around 5:15 a.m. for excessive window tint when officers noticed a strong smell of alcohol. Edwards' blood alcohol level was twice the legal limit. In January, Edwards was placed on probation after pleading no contest to misdemeanor aggravated disorderly conduct in Cleveland. He was accused of punching a man outside a nightclub. General Manager Mike Tannenbaum said Edwards showed poor judgment and noted the Jets have a special program for players that provide them rides free of charge for just such an occasion. Everybody is saying this is serious, and it is, but I bet you lunch he'll play this Sunday.
He will.
He will?
Yeah, he will.
So he won't start, but he'll play?
Yep.
I'll take a chicken Caesar salad and extra croutons with my wrap for sports and entertainment. And now, on this day in Black history, the great leader of the Zulu Kingdom, Shaka Zulu, was assassinated by members of his inner circle. Shaka was by far the most influential king of the Zulu tribe and is widely credited with creating the Zulu nation. He was considered a military genius for his reforms and innovations, but was likewise condemned for his brutality. The Zulu monarch's erratic behavior after the death of his mother when he ordered all pregnant women killed led to his death at the hands of his brothers on this day in 1828. Well, that's it for us here at Black TV 24/7 News. For more information on the stories covered during this newscast, please visit us at blacktv247news.com and click on the story links. Until tomorrow, I'm Erin Elkins. Have a benevolent Wednesday. And remember, you can catch us online 24/7.